So happy holidays from Decker's Nursery. Today we're working in the outdoor production area. This is where we make a lot of the custom wreaths, the memorial blankets, and then my job each year is to make the holiday decor pots. And it's something I look forward to each year. This is a lot of customers come in to buy the materials to make them the pots themselves. So I'm going to show you how I make this decor pot so that you might have some fun at home doing this yourself. So most of everything that I'm going to use today, you can gather from your landscape. If there's some plants or pots or boughs here that you want to use, we do have them available at Decker's Nursery. And one thing I'll tell you is, when I make the decor pots, they're more of a one-sided design. So they would sit on the front porch or on the outdoor living areas and be viewed from one side. So as I'm making this, I'll be turning the container so you can get an idea. So this is very easy to do, and I'm going to move through it pretty quickly, but you'll see how this pot of potting soil becomes a holiday decor pot. So the first thing I start with are branches. These can come from your Christmas tree, or if you have a spruce tree in the backyard, and I try to use a lot of these full ones just to really give me a backdrop, take up a lot of the space. You can make this as dense as you want or as thin as you want. And I try to get to about the halfway point with the balsam or spruce boughs. So you can see they're all facing a certain direction, and I just set them down into the soil enough so that they're supported. And you can see I'm trying to get height in the middle and work out a little bit. So this branch is very well positioned to make the pot look much larger, but I need to balance that on this side a little bit. So maybe one or two smaller ones up front, and I think I'm there. So this is kind of your starting point, all right? And it's just any branches from an evergreen that will give you this type of texture, okay? Now what I want to do is diversify the types of greens that I'm using. So boxwood is very effective. It has that glossy appearance. So these were harvested from my backyard, and you can see how it gives a nice contrast. And I cut them, you can cut them small or large. Here's a smaller piece I put up front, and you know, just a little bit of balance across the front. I try not to leave any stubs on the branches so that they look natural. Okay, how's that coming? Okay, so right now that gives me that contrast that I was talking about. White pine is really effective. So I try to put that in with the larger boughs, and it just gives you that different texture that I keep talking about. Some of the smaller pieces work well up in the front where they give you a little bit of a weeping or trailing effect. So I'm going to add a couple more pine boughs through the center of the arrangement, more for balance. So if you do it on one side, try to do it on the other as well. And they don't all have to be large pieces. So you can, like here's a lot of smaller ones, and I'm going to use this right in the center. It gives me a lot more height. Okay, and now I want to finish off the front. Some of the options for you are you can use buried juniper, which is really effective because it has a whole different color and texture. So this could work. The one I really enjoy using is incense cedar. So it has a nice soft texture. The cones are decorative, and you can mix in. The more you mix in, the more diverse the appearance is. So this came together pretty quickly, as you see. Now I want to put some of the finishing touches on it. So I pulled a spray from one of our display units in the florist area. So I'm going to put this in the center. So this gives me some really nice bold colors, spread it out a little bit, and it looks like it's been there forever. It just kind of melds into the arrangement. The bow we made, and I'll put this in at the end, and it just gives you that festive appearance. If you've ever seen the branches at the garden centers, this is what we use them for. You can use them in your landscape beds just for some added color. I like to cut my branches smaller and put a lot of them in versus like one big piece. Like that's a large piece that you could just pop into the center. And you just take these apart, just dismantle them. You know, at the branch unions. So how's that looking? So I have white going all the way across. Now I'm mixing a little more red. Okay. So I hope this looks all right. It's hard to do it in reverse. So I have the red and the white branches give me some contrast. Now I want to make it a little festive. I'll use one of the ornamental millimeter balls. You can use pine cones. And this is where you should have fun. The other thing I've used in some of these are the curly willow. This is a lot of fun to work with. This is what I used in my own decor pots. But anyway, this is how easy it is. And, you know, we'll put the last finishing touch on as a red bow so that it looks like holiday season. So I hope this helps and gives you some inspiration. Start gathering any of the greens from your gardens, or come on down and we'll show you what we have available for you. Have a great holiday season. Thank you.